I will show you to use my admin panel, which I made a while ago. Let me show you how to use the model, which is in the description down below. So if you click on admin, only a few people can get it. We get the search username, type in username you liked or you like. I banned this for fun. You get the image, you get status, if it's banned or not, username and user ID. It also has a out search bar. As you can see, it gets my username, I'm unban, player ID, you can kick, ban or unban. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention here we have a little help button. My old account is unban, let's ban him with the message, you are banned for the video, ban. Alright, let's get my old account. As you can see, the reason is you are banned for the video. Right, let's go unban him. And as you can see, it says he is banned. Let's unban him. Boom. Now if we join again, as you can see, I am in the game with him right now. Hey, can you message me Twitter if you see this? Let's click on ban, and boom, there it is. So that's basically how it works. So if you get the model, you have to put the admin panel is server storage, not a started UI, but a server storage. We get the admin frame and the toggle button. And let's go over the code real quick. Here we get the toggle script, here we get the basic things. We get let the GUI come in if the toggle button is clicked. Here we make function find player. This finds the player you want to have information of. We get a reload function to reload everything. A setup function, suggestion function. This is the auto suggestion. Here it suggests player. This part. And this is when the suggestion is clicked. Here we have the search bar where we've searched all the players. And the right side with the ban. This is the ban button. Here we have the unban, the kick button. Unban button. And this says if the player is banned or not. So this all sends information to the server using some remote events, which are stored in replicate storage. So put all those remote events right here. Let's go to server script service. We have the giving UI thing. Here we have, here you put user ID from those you want to give it to. If you don't know the user ID, you have to go to view, the comment bar and the output. And let's say print game of players. Get user ID from name sync. Type your username you want and press enter. Here you see my user ID, which is right here. Put a comma, enter, and put the user ID there. That's everything. Let's go to the server script. Here we get the, here we make data store for the ban value. Here we get a whole player edit function, which checks if the player is banned or not. Here we get a ban request to ban the player. Here we kick the player. Here we check if the player is banned or not and send that to the client so the admin will see it. And here we do the unban thing. So if you want to unban someone, you can do that with two ways, just with the GUI or using the data store editor. I'll show you how to use that. Get the user ID remember, this data store never could never change that. Here we get the key, this is important. Get your user ID, paste it here, copy this, press Ctrl G, so this stays here. Get to the plugins tab, data store editor. We don't have scope, only the name. Key, as you can see, the first one will be the ban message. And the second one says if the player is banned or not. One is just it's just text, but only shows up when the player is banned. If this says true, the player is banned. If you want to change this to false, and click save. And that's actually how it works. Hope you enjoy. Feel free to ask questions. If you enjoyed this, please leave a like, share this video, comment and subscribe, and see you later.